Welcome to The Animated Engineer, the channel where we break down complex engineering topics into simple visual stories. In today's video, we're diving into energy storage. What it is, why it matters, and how it's shaping the future of our power grids. Energy storage is exactly what it sounds like, capturing energy when it's available and releasing it when it's needed. Think of it as a giant battery for the grid. It helps balance supply and demand, especially as we shift toward renewable sources like wind and solar. Here's why energy storage is critical. One, it reduces curtailment of clean energy. Two, it smooths out fluctuations in supply and demand. Three, it supports grid stability and frequency control. Four, it helps lower costs and improves reliability. Five, it's essential for integrating more renewables into the system. In April 2025, Spain and Portugal experienced a massive blackout. Investigations revealed that low levels of conventional generation, poor voltage control systems. This trend has been increasing over the last several years as the more renewables have been coming onto the system. In addition, the number of coupled thermal plants was at its lowest of the year, reducing the system inertia and reactive power controlled. As conventional generation continued to drop from the grid, around 10:30, the system began experiencing voltage deviations beyond acceptable thresholds, marked repeatedly by red line indicators, before ultimately descending into instability. The delayed response to earlier warning signs led to cascading failures, resulting in over 2,000 megawatts of renewable generation was lost in seconds. Before this sudden loss of power, the system started to become unstable with large frequency oscillations. This event underscored the urgent need to reassess grid inertia, strengthen and review control systems, and invest in damping technologies like energy storage to prevent future incidents of this scale.
There are many types of energy storage, each with different strengths. Batteries, fast, flexible, but limited duration. Ultracapacitors, great for quick bursts. Flywheels, mechanical, fast response. Pumped hydro, large scale, long duration. Compressed air, similar to hydro, but uses air. Thermal storage, stores heat for later use. Gravity-based, lifts and drops weights to store energy. Each technology fits a different part of the power duration curve, from seconds to hours or even days. Now let's dive further into some of these technologies. Flywheel energy storage, FES. FES systems store energy by rapidly rotating a heavy disk, sometimes reaching speeds of up to 60,000 RPM. They're ideal for short-duration grid support, offering fast frequency stabilization and load balancing. Thanks to their robust design, they boast exceptionally long service lives and require minimal upkeep. Depending on the setup, the rotor may be suspended using either magnetic or mechanical bearings, each offering distinct advantages in terms of friction and durability. Compressed air energy storage, CAES. CAES works by forcing air into deep underground spaces, usually abandoned gas fields or salt caverns, where it's held under pressure. When energy demand spikes, the stored air is released to spin turbines and generate electricity. While the system is relatively efficient and can store large amounts of energy, its deployment is constrained by geological availability, as only certain formations are suitable for safe and effective storage. Pump storage hydropower, PSH. PSH is the most widely used form of grid-scale storage. It pumps water uphill when demand is low and releases it to generate electricity when demand spikes. It's efficient, durable, and can respond in seconds.
Time to explore how these three technologies stack up.
1. Pumped hydro. Long duration, massive capacity, ideal for grid balancing. 2. Flywheels, fast response, short duration, great for frequency control. 3. CAES, medium duration, large capacity, location dependent. Now let's look at a real world example. Turlock Hill, perched in the Wicklow Mountains, is Ireland's only pumped storage power station and has been a cornerstone of grid stability since it became fully operational in 1974. The facility uses two reservoirs, one at the summit
and one at the base, to store and release energy by pumping water uphill during low demand and generating electricity as it flows back down during peak demand. At the time of construction, the project cost 22 million pounds Irish pounds, which was a significant amount of money at the time. The station houses four reversible pump turbine generators, each rated at 73 megawatts, giving it a total installed capacity of 292 megawatts. It can ramp from zero to full output in about 70 seconds, making it ideal for peak shaving and emergency response. Even today, Turlock Hill remains a vital asset, especially as Ireland integrates more renewables.
As we move toward a cleaner, greener grid, energy storage will be the backbone of reliability. Whether it's flywheels, compressed air, or pumped hydro, storage is what makes renewables truly work.